do. But we'll keep you close as always. It won't even seem you've gone. Cause our hearts in big and small ways will keep the love that keeps us strong.
Thanks to my teacher, especially Mr. Adcox, Ms. Obershane, Mr. Kohler, and Mr. Boot.
So how much are you going to miss your locker?
Well, not too much, considering I don't really keep anything in it.
Oh, you don't? Let's see. That's it?
Yeah.
Oh, there they are. They haven't moved in about 6 months.
Pretty much.
How much are you going to miss the hallways here?
Not at all. They all smell.
Really?
Each has its own distinct smell.
Really?
Yeah.
Anything
for real.
You want to say that's how it smells?
Not really. Yeah, that's pretty much it.
Anything you want to say to the class of 96?
Just good luck and have fun next year.
What do you want to say to everyone?
Nice knowing you. See you around.
How about you, man? Tell us about it.
It's good to be graduating. That's about all I got to say.
Good luck in the next couple of years.
What was high school like?
It was pretty good, meeting everybody and friends.
What's it like to know that high school is over? I mean, just like that, 4 years, it's over.
It's kind of scary to think about, but it's exciting too at the same time because we don't know what lies ahead of us and what we're going to do.
How about you? Your thoughts?
Well, I'm glad we're graduating. Finally, it's been 4 years. I just want to tell everybody I hope they're happy in the future and good luck.
How about you?
I just want to tell everybody good luck in the future and have fun. Wish everybody a lot of luck.
I'm going to remember the teammates policy. Hope that's out of high school.
How about yourself?
Yeah, I wish everybody the best of luck in the future. And I'd say the most memorable thing I remember is sports.
Sports?
Yep, just sports.
Yeah. How about yourself?
Good luck to class and good luck to Ms. Hall, our government teacher, which is great. And that's it. Good luck.
You made an A in that class, didn't you?
Yeah, I'm exempt from all my exams. I think that's the way to go out, not taking any exams your senior year. So, way to go, brother.
Nice job.
I just want to wish good luck to everyone, all the success and all the happiness.
Yeah.
I just want to wish everybody good luck and hope they make many more friends in the future.
Go ahead.
I'm going to remember French class and having fun at lunch and everything.
Go ahead.
Oh gosh, I'm gonna remember my marketing class and my chemistry class. I had chemistry and it was like all three seniors set up front. We would have a countdown of days from 180 days. It was great. Miss J, we would just drive her crazy. I'm gonna remember all of our friends and that's about it.
I'm gonna remember all my friends and all the good times I had, especially Fatty Kristen in front of me. And in the future, I wish that everybody would keep our world clean and safe.
You gave me wings and made me fly. You touched my hand, I could touch the sky. I lost my faith, you gave it back to me. You said no star was out of reach. You stood by me and asked the toll I had you.
really going to remember all the people and all the fun we had in high school. And I hope everybody the best of luck, and I hope everything comes true for them that they want.
Good job.
Same here.
What high school teach you?
What high school teach me?
Mm-hmm.
To sleep really good on the weekends.
Mm-hmm. Till about noon every day, right?
Something like that, yeah.
Mm-hmm. What you?
I hope everybody has a lot of joy in life, and I'm really going to remember my German class and all the friends that I made.
I'm going to remember all the great school dances.
Really? What were those like?
Oh, so much fun. Sitting down, talking to my friends, getting up and dancing.
How about you?
I'm going to remember my best friend, Laura.
Hi, Laura.
And biology class and green pins for me.
That's funny. I'm going to remember my best friend Amber and all the people I met, and I'm going to wish everyone the best of luck in life.
Good.
My wildest experience.
Yeah, what was it?
Well, baseball's pretty wild.
How do you guys think it?
Yeah, I ran into it through the halls.
What happened?
Nah. Probably when I was, like, one of my friends decided to, like, run from the police. For just, like, a speeding ticket for like 5-0 or something.
Did he get caught?
Yeah, we got caught.
Yeah.
Wow.
That was pretty cool. But I didn't get in any trouble, so it was, you know, that was fun.
Okay. Please back in. How about yourself?
Most memorable moments at high school are waiting after school to lift weights with Mike Johnson and just me and my friends just boosting school with Roma.
I remember my friends Katrina and Amanda and all the great times I had in government class and big reports I had to do standing up in front of the classroom.
Gym class because we never played any sports. Mr. Prey couldn't get us off the bench because we would discuss political issues and just everything. He got really mad at us for that.
I don't know. I don't remember much of high school. I slept through quite a fair amount of it. But what I do remember, it's an okay place to be social-wise, education-wise, I think. I don't know. I think I'll just leave this school here, leaving my mark here and there, and just saying good luck to everybody. And, well, I just hope that they can have the same experience as I had in this wonderful Lord Bata High School. And never quite... I'll never be the same after this. Thank you.
It went by really fast.
What was so fast about it?
It was just like... It seems like yesterday we were in ninth grade goofing around, and it comes to reality that you can't goof around. We're graduating in less than a week.
High school, what are you going to remember about it?
I guess the faculty game, Chad Beck shooting 15 threes and not making any of them. Not making any of them.
Did anyone say them? Go ahead. Did anyone say the class in 96?
Physics rules. That'll be it, probably.
After high school, what are you going to remember about it?
It was fun, I guess. Just that easy, no responsibilities or anything. Just living life, I don't know.
Not going to be like that in the real world, is it?
Nope.
High school was fun. So you could be a kid and play.
Going to miss it?
Probably not, but well, I'll remember it. Probably not
miss it. I'm missing you. I lie awake tonight and I watch the sky. And I wish.
What do you think college will be like?
It'll be fun. A lot of parties.
Nice job. Tell us about high school. What was it like?
Well, it was fun. It had its bad moments, of course, but I've made a lot of good friends, and I had a lot of fun.
Gonna miss it?
Yes, I will, but I'm looking forward to college, so.
Nice job. The class of 96, has it hit you yet? You're graduating.
Not yet. It doesn't seem like it's time to graduate. I think the years have just flown by.
How about it, man? How's it feel to graduate?
Feels good.
Hard to believe it's all over?
Yep.
What do you want to say to the class of 96?
Just succeed in life.
Pretty much. I guess I've been here for 5 years. I said.
5 years, huh?
Yeah, I dropped out last year.
Did you really?
Yeah,
glad you're back, though, huh?
Yeah, I'm glad to get my diploma.
What feel to be graduating?
Great, man.
Really? Why is that?
Just to get out of here.
What are you doing after high school?
Partying.
Well, what are you going to remember about high school?
That I had a lot to offer.
Yeah,
good lunch food and stuff like that.
Was it good, really?
Yeah.
What tastes better, going over to Texas Steakhouse or eating here at Botetourt High School?
Oh, steakhouse. No doubt.
Looking back on the memory of the dance we shared beneath the stars above. For a moment, all the world was right. How could I have known that you'd ever say goodbye? And now, I'm glad I didn't know the way it all would end.
Wish the class 96?
Good luck, and I hope they get far in life. It's a different experience. Everything's hard to a point, and it's just something new we're trying. This is all, now we're ready for something new.
Nice.
Everybody has good luck. Thank you.
And what exactly are you going to do after high school?
I have no idea.
Not sure, huh?
Yeah, I'm going to return all my clothes. Okay, what do you want me to say?
What do you
want
to say?
Absolutely nothing. No, I don't know. What do you want me
How about
say?
A wish? You'd like to make the class
a
pass?
Wish? Yeah. The school gets renovated, finally, even though we're leaving, but...
Good. I like that. What about you?
I just like to hope that everybody does well and everything and has good luck.
How are you going to remember high school?
All the friends and the fun times that we had.
Hard to believe it's over.
Yeah, it's finally over. We're waiting for it.
Our lives are better left to chance. I could have missed the pain, but I'd have had to miss the dance. Everything for a moment wasn't I king? But if I'd only know how the king would fall, hey, who's to say? You know I might have changed it all. And I'm glad I
did. School,
good luck.
What are you doing after high school?
I got a job at Regis at Tanglewood Mall.
Really? So do you want to wish everybody good luck?
Yes.
Jess, how about you, man? Tell us about it. What's going through your mind right now, a week before you graduate?
I just can't wait to get out of school.
Why is that?
Start life. Get out of the house, move away.
A wish. You'd like to send a class in 96?
Just to do their best and to wish them all the good luck that they can need.
How about never quitting? Tell them to talk about that. Never quit.
The worst thing they could do would be drop out and quit.
Beautiful. How about you?
See you guys at Western. Just good luck, I guess.
It's all over.
I know. I mean, I'll miss all my friends and
when they hate it, you know what I mean? Just, I mean, especially in that Robert and Michael Follies, you know? He's playing on the basketball team together and everything.
How sad is it to leave? I mean, this is it, man. I don't know if it has hit you yet, but high school's over.
Yeah, it is. I guess, you know, you got to start life now, you know? You got all this stuff in front of you, and I mean, you're leaving everybody behind.
What do you want to say to class of 96?
God bless. Good luck. I'm going to need it, I know that.
Like this one right here.
Really?
Yeah.
What are you gonna make on this test here?
I was shooting for 100, but if I can't answer this one, I don't know.
Do a class 96.
We don't have a lot of time. We got a
little. Well, I think we have a good class. So yeah. I'm glad I'm graduating with them, and I think that there's a lot of potential, and I think that 10 years from now, you'll find out that these kids that you don't think a lot of now are going to actually really do something with themselves.
Nice job. How about yourself? What do you want to say to everyone?
Hi.
What was high school like for you?
It was interesting. It's really interesting.
How about yourself? What was high school like?
It was a really good time. I'm glad I'm out of here, though, and goodbye and good luck.
Come on up here.
I don't want to.
High school, what was it like for you?
It was good. Good luck to everybody and have everybody successful.
It was fun, and just everybody have fun and don't forget to party.
Good luck, class of 96!
Gym class sophomore year, how we had to run the mile, and I always had chocolate donuts and french fries and chocolate milk, and had to run the mile after that, and it was really revolting.
I just think about all the people and all the different things we've done, and that's all. I just think about all the friends that I'm going to miss when I'm gone at college. It's going to be really sad.
I'm going to miss that we had pizza every Friday, every single year, and now I'm really tired of it.
I like the excitement of senior year and graduating and the end of the year.
I just think of how glad I am to be getting out of here.
Really? You don't want to stick around and be a freshman next year?
No, thanks.
Start all over?
No, thanks.
How about you?
Think about year after year, smelling the halls. It smells terrible here.
Really?
That's what I think about.
Oh, come on.
The smell of LBHS. The food is pretty awful.
Hi, I'm doing this for Mr. Week because I love our girls' basketball team. I just remember our girls winning the state AA championship, and I was cheering for them.
The memories of tennis, man.
The memories of tennis are great. To the class of 96, I say good luck because we're going to need it.
What you gonna miss the hallways here, Lord Botetourt?
Not much at all, really. I've been here 4 years and I'm about ready to get out, actually.
Really? Where are you going after high school?
I'm gonna head to Radford. And, first of all, I'm gonna go to the beach this summer and just have a good time. And then go to school for another 4 years.
You gonna miss high school?
Yeah.
What did it teach you?
Would it teach me?
Yeah.
Tolerance.
I guess I just miss the people, not the classes.
You mean
really?
The guys?
Why is that?
The guys.
The what?
Joke.
The guys.
The guys.
Really?
A big joke.
Tell us about what you learned in high school. What did you learn?
I don't remember going to classes, do you?
Well, how much are you going to miss high school?
A whole lot.
Why is that?
Because all my friends are here. Well, I mean, I have senior friends and stuff, but not from my underclassmen.
Yeah. Actually, I'm not really going to miss all that much. All I can say is after graduation, I can't wait. Because I'm going to, go down and see Margaritaville. Yeah.
You in the color guard?
Uh-huh.
What was that like?
It was it's very hard, but it was fun.
Tell us about UVA, man. What's it like to know you're going to University of Virginia next year?
I'm not going there.
You're not?
No. Tech.
Must be a Cavalier fan.
Hokey.
Hey, how about making a 4.0 in high school? What was that like?
Oh, that didn't happen much.
What do I want to say to everyone? Oh, man. Senior class of 96. We're just awesome. And I have 4 days left in this place, and I'm out of here. I'm out of Botetourt County because I'm so sick of it. I'm so sick of everybody else. I love my friends and my family, but all my enemies, man, you guys know what you can do. Just leave me alone. Don't ever talk to me again. I'm out of here in 4 days.
Good job.
That's all I have to say.
That's about,
that's really close.
What's it like to know you're graduating?
Very exciting. It's also very scary. You wait for this for 4 years, and then it gets here, and you're like, am I really ready for this? It's cool.
Hard to believe, isn't it?
Yeah, really, really hard to believe. But I think it'll be cool. We're all really excited.
So is this what you wear to school every day?
Yeah, actually, it's sort of a mixture between this barbaric look and more of a Renaissance nude look, yeah. I've gone with the barbaric look today just due to the fact that silver went best with black. Oh, that's just sort of the
looks great.
In big and small ways, we keep the love that keeps us strong.
A lot. I'm especially gonna miss being with my friends and hanging out and basically doing nothing my senior year, because you don't really have a lot of pressure once you've gotten into a school.
How about the real world? What's that gonna be like?
I imagine it's gonna be really scary, but it's gotta be fun. I mean, it's gonna have to be better than sitting around Lower Botetourt High School.
How much are you gonna miss high school?
Not at all.
What's that smile on your face all about, man? You look like you're happy to leave.
Well, sort of.
Really?
Yeah. I'll miss a few things, but...
What are you going to miss?
Let's see. My friends. Things like that.
Good job. Well, what do you want to say to the class of 96?
That I'll miss you, and it's been great being with you for 4 years. Good luck to y'all.
Well, I hope you all the best of luck, and I hope you all have fun too.
And friends are friends forever, if the Lord's the Lord of them. And a friend will not say never, cause the welcome will not end. Though it's hard to let you go, in the Father's hands we know that a lifetime's not too long. This friend's God's given, springing from the hole. you show, but we'll keep you close as always. If only you even seen you've gone, cause our hearts in big and small ways will keep the love.
Represents many things to our graduates. It means the end of our high school careers, the end of life as we know it. Although nothing will be comparable to our past, we have many promising endeavors in our future. As we walk across this stage, our lives are just beginning. To the faculty, I hope you remember our class fondly. We are a class possessing great strength, leadership, and undeniable character. As we enter the fabled world of adulthood, our memories of LBHS will remain with us through the years. We will remember how all of you, teachers, coaches, and counselors, guided us toward the path of success. To our parents, grandparents, family, and friends, you also have played an important role in our lives. Molding and sculpting our character, you have made us the people who stand before you tonight. Your support and encouragement helps us to keep going day after day. And finally, to all the graduates, here we go. As everything ends tonight, there will be many new beginnings in the coming months. I hope each of you will be proud of our class, for we have accomplished many things individually and as the class of 1996. I wish for you all a lifetime full of challenges, discoveries, excitement, and success. As we sit here tonight, we realize that this ceremony symbolizes everything we have achieved and accomplished over the past 4 years. As Ralph Waldo Emerson once said, "The reward of a thing well done is to have done it." And so, class of 96, we have done it.
Graduation from high school is a significant achievement in the lives of these young women and men. Each of them began their early learning in life with basic common sense, but to it they applied the power of reasoning, aided by the observation and methods of science and life. To observe, reason, and think critically are natural consequences of learning. Those who develop the knack of consequential thinking find today's world a much less puzzling and frightening place. Good thinkers understand things better, and consequently are better able to plan and control their activities than are people who think less clearly. Today, it is more important than ever before to think as clearly as possible. The faculty of Lord Botetourt High School and the school board administration attest these graduates are thinkers and are ready educationally to enter the next phase of their lives. For you graduates here tonight, you have a lot to be grateful for. Many have worked hard with you, and much has been sacrificed for you. There are individuals here tonight, as well as others, to whom you owe a major, who you owe a major amount of gratitude. You should be grateful for their education that they have offered to you, and don't forget that, please. As you leave here tonight, take with you these few words of wisdom. Every person you meet knows something you don't. Learn from them. Remember, no one makes it alone. Have a grateful heart and be quick to acknowledge those who help you. Focus on making things better, not bigger. Become someone's hero. Count your blessings. And to expound on an axiom from Steven Spielberg's universal philosopher, E.T., phone home and tell Mom what's happening. Members of the school board congratulate the 1996 graduates, wish them success, and urge them to think clearly and positively as they venture through life.
Tragedies that have occurred during our senior year.
But we should not dwell upon these things, for as one philosopher said, the gem cannot be polished without friction, nor man perfected without trials. The characteristic that makes this class different is that we have overcome these trials together. By reaching down and picking up a friend, by crying together, by listening to problems, and by sharing the happy times together. We often take for granted the things that most deserve our gratitude. Without an excellent staff at Lord Botetourt High School, it would have been impossible for us to recover from these hardships. I am appreciative to have principals who care about each of us, teachers who want us to succeed, and an overall exceptional staff. Most of us have been fortunate enough to have families and friends who cared about us. For 4 years, they have supported us in everything that we have done. Our families have provided for us financially and have been alongside of us, experiencing the high school years all over again. They are truly worthy of our appreciation. The future holds exciting, challenging times that will again test our values and our faith. My advice to the graduating class of 1996 is best said in the words of Thomas Jefferson. In matters of style, swim with the current. In matters of principle, stand like a rock. Never let yourself down by doing less than your best. As Mark 9, verse 23 states, everything is possible for him who believes. Thanks again to the staff, family, and friends here today. Congratulations and good luck to all of you. Thank you.
Friends, family, faculty, and my fellow graduates, the time has come for us to shut the door on our high school years and to move on to yet unforeseeable challenges. As we journey into the unknown, I ask the class of 1996 to always retain one quality above all others. Never lose the ability we all have as children to distinguish right from wrong. Do not let the temptations of success cloud your ability to judge the good from the bad, because success is not tangible. Money can burn, trophies can break, and medals can rust. Success is not sports cars in your garage or the size of your bank account. To be successful, you must have a positive effect on your fellow man. A successful person is one who volunteers in his or her community and serves as a pillar of strength for all of society. Success should be measured by the respect you earn, not the money you make. To be successful as a group, we must change the wrongs we felt so powerless against as children, because now we have the power to change all the wrongs that afflict our beloved society. Now is our time to rage against the bigots, to rage against the hate that threatens to tear our melting pot into pieces. Now is our time to rage against all that is wrong, and when we are successful, America can then be called the land of the free and the home of the brave. I leave the words of Dylan Thomas to my friends. Do not go quietly into that good night. Old age should burn and ray the close of day. Rage, rage against the dying of the light. Thank you.
Last weekend, I was playing at Botetourt Country Club. myself, why would anybody play this stupid game? Anyone who hits a little white ball and then chases after it 70 to 100 times in 4 hours must be insane. By this time, I was on number 7, a long par 4, which is probably the toughest hole at the country club. I stood on the tee and drew back my driver with a rhythmic pace and swung through the ball, hitting the most beautiful tee shot that sailed through the silent air like a white bird. I looked around in awe at the beauty that surrounded me, thought golf is a lot like life. Some of your greatest moments come in the middle of hardship. The hardship we have shared this year is incomparable to anything in the history of our school. We must remember the past while striving for the future. I envision tonight as the beginning of the most important round of golf in our lives. We stand here on the first tee this evening and look down that long fairway of life, surrounded by water and trees, only to see that white flag waving in the wind 400 yards away. That flag is our goal for the next year or so. Then we will begin another hole in our lives. We stand beside our bag of decisions and choose our clubs carefully. We ask ourselves, do I want to lay up short of trouble, or do I risk it and hit it over the blue monster of defeat? You must decide tonight and in the coming years what you want to do. Remember that in life, as in golf, everyone is a winner. No one loses unless he quits. Even if you hit it in the water or get stuck behind a tree, remember you have unlimited opportunities in which to reach your goal. Whether it takes 4 swings or 104, remember that once you reach that cup of success, you have completed a journey which no one can take from you. I would like to thank those people who have helped me accomplish some of my goals. The most important of these are my 3 closest friends. My mother and father have stood behind me in everything I've done and have taught me that perseverance is the key to success. I wish to especially thank my brother who walked across this stage 7 years ago. Sam, thank you for being a great brother and role model. I cannot think of a greater person to follow in life. And on behalf of the senior class, I want to thank the whole Lord Botetourt faculty, and especially Ms. Suters, for supporting our class in everything we have done. Ms. Suters, would you please come forward to receive a gift of appreciation from the class of 1996? As we leave tonight in separate directions and on separate paths, I want us to remember the memories we have shared with others here at Lord Botetourt. I am proud to be a part of the class of 1996, and I would like to leave you with a quote from Walt Disney. All our dreams can come true if we have the courage to pursue them. Good luck to all of you in the future.
As I was looking for some inspiration in writing my speech, I wandered outside and sat on my favorite bench for a few moments in the quiet evening hours. After some time, it began to get rather dark, and I happened to spot a firefly or two as I was gazing out into the yard. Suddenly, I realized what a short time ago it seemed, that I had chased fireflies in the summer evenings without a care in the world. At first, I longed for those days of constant relaxation to return, but I realized how much I have grown and that responsibilities are a major part of the passage to adulthood. We are now at what is perhaps the most significant turning point in our lives, and we have grown up and reached this point together. I can remember being a frightened freshman wandering through the halls of a strange new school, trying to figure out what I'd done to deserve this sudden demotion from the status of an eighth grader. However, as the years wore on, we seemed to find our places in high school, and to discover our talents and our personalities. Many of us have become athletes, some are musicians, artists, or writers. Some of us are leaders, and some are followers. As we began to discover ourselves, the last of our childhood gradually slipped through our fingers, and we gained new responsibilities at an incredible speed. Now we are at the end of our last year in high school. For all of its excitements and good times, this year has been a difficult one for all of us. Together, we have felt the strain of planning our lives after LB, and have felt the disappointment of each new event possibly being the last of its kind. Most of all, if we did not know already, this year we learned the pain of losing classmates and loved ones. Friendships which have lasted forever may soon be parting ways, yet hopefully not forgotten. However, we have made it this far and will begin looking to our futures. I would like to give thought to a simple metaphor. It is said that when a storm is approaching, each and every animal seeks shelter except for one. When an eagle senses a coming storm, it does not hide, but spreads its wings and faces the tempest head on, allowing the winds of the storm to catch its wings and send it soaring so that it may ride safely above the clouds. Although we have come a long way from catching fireflies in the dusk, most of the time when life has been a challenge, we have had the guidance and support of our parents. If not for their sacrifices, I feel that we would never have made it to this point in our lives, and I think they must know how much they are appreciated. However, as we step out of these doors, we will begin facing life's trials on our own. Sometimes it will be difficult, but it is my hope that we all have the ability to face and overcome our obstacles just as the eagle does. Class of 1996, I wish you all the best of luck and the greatest of success.
Parents, family, friends, faculty, and fellow graduates, I decided to get the sentimental part over with first. It was the worst of times, it was the worst of times. That certainly may have seemed true on those days when the biology classes were dissecting something slimy and the plumbing broke, or on those days when someone found milk and opened it that had been in their locker for 3 months, or basically any day when that incredible smell that it seems only our school has filled the hallways. Yes, those days made us wish that this day would just get here fast. Now that it is, I still can't say that I will miss those particular days. But even though 2 weeks ago, when I was struggling to finish all of those special projects that were all too popular among my teachers, to send out graduation announcements, to help our softball team make it to the regionals, to tie up all those loose ends, when I was on the edge with not enough sleep, not enough time, not enough caffeine, it seemed this day couldn't come fast enough. And you couldn't pay me enough to say this. But now I see that I will treasure the experiences I've had here forever. Before my next remark, I'd like to remind you all that denial is an ugly thing. Lord Botetourt High School will always hold a very special place in our lives, and yes, in our hearts. Admitting it is the first step. I'm not here tonight to lecture you about life, even though when I'm finished, you'll probably think otherwise. I'm certainly not an authority, but what I have to say to you is something that I've learned over the years, and it's advice that I try to follow. As we leave here and go out into the world, as we begin a long journey to find out who we are and who we want to be, I'd like for all of us to give these few things consideration. It should be pretty obvious to all of you that Botetourt County is a small, small place on this earth. Realize that beyond the life you know here is an entire world, not just filled with countries, but with people, opportunities, and experiences. Get out of here. Travel. Make an effort to meet new people and to try new things. When I went to Europe, the minute I arrived in the airport in London, a man walked up to me, read the address label on my suitcase, and spat out the word Americans in a disgusted voice. Some people with whom we tried to communicate laughed at us. Others were downright rude and hostile. But that was all forgotten when we met those who wanted to try out their English, those who were tourists from other countries just like we were, or those who were just being friendly. In one museum in France, we happened to start talking to a couple of security guards. It turned out that one knew quite a bit of English, and furthermore, had been to Virginia and loved the Chesapeake Bay. The other spoke no English at all, but he was a huge fan of Elvis, as am I, and wore a necklace with a guitar charm on it and an Elvis ID bracelet. He gave us his address with the hopes that someday, if we ever went to Graceland, we would send him a postcard. My experiences were both positive and negative, but I would not trade any of them. For the most important things a person learns come not from books, but from interactions with other people. While someone whose ideas and thoughts and traditions may seem foreign and may seem very intimidating, these are the people who have the most to teach us. Some will be willing and others won't, but don't give up on the challenge. Learn to embrace diversity rather than running away from it. In meeting all the new people that you will, I urge you to keep an open mind. Do not judge others in haste or unjustly.
respect for people's different beliefs and ideas. However, do not be afraid to have your own, and do not hesitate to voice your opinion. Be an individual. Shakespeare once said that the world is a stage, the men and women only players. I tend to disagree with this statement in that it implies that we all have our parts written for us, and we merely follow along. I believe that each of us writes our own script, and that we should resist the roles that peers, family, and society would have us play unless they are the ones that our hearts truly wish to follow. In life, work hard and be successful, but use your own definition of success. First and foremost, make sure that you are happy and content. Determine what things are important to you, and then grab hold of them and don't let them go. But once you have made your way in this world, remember that you did not do it alone. We are all a product of our environment. I would not be in this position tonight had I not received incredible support from my family, my teachers, my friends, and others in the community. Most likely, neither would you. Each of these people deserve our sincere thanks for having been there for us. No matter where you are or what you do, do not forget these people. We are in debt to them and should, in our lives, try to repay some of what we owe by returning and giving back to our community all that they have given to us. I hope some of what I've said here tonight has caused you to think and reflect and has meant something to you. If not, I hope that you will keep it in the back of your mind in the hopes that someday it will. I wish each of you in the class of 1996 the best of luck until we meet again. Congratulations. You guys are the best. Don't forget to come to the reunions. Thank you.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and my congratulations to the class of 96. You have been receiving 4 years of advice, sometimes from me, sometimes appreciated and sometimes not quite so appreciated. But tonight I feel that I would be remiss if I didn't give you one more piece of advice, and I plan to do that this evening. I think it would be advice that everyone could benefit from. In looking for something to say tonight, I found a short piece by Robert Hastings, and it's called The Station. I hope you'll listen to that. Very brief, and I'd like to share that with you. Tucked away in our subconscious is an idyllic vision. We see ourselves on a long trip that spans the continent. We are traveling by train. Out the windows, we drink in the passing scene of cars on nearby highways, of children waving at a crossing, of cattle grazing on a distant hillside, of smoke pouring from a power plant, of row upon row of corn and wheat, of flatlands and valleys, of mountains and rolling hillsides, of city skylines and village halls. But uppermost in our minds is the final destination. On a certain day, at a certain time, we will pull into the station. Bands will be playing, flags will be waving. Once we get there, so many wonderful dreams will come true, and the pieces of our lives will fit together like a complicated jigsaw puzzle. How restlessly we pace the aisles, waiting, waiting, waiting for the station. When we reach the station, that will be it, we cry. When I'm 18, when I buy a new 450 SL Mercedes-Benz, when I put the last kid through college, when I've paid off the mortgage, when I get a promotion, when I reach the age of retirement, I shall live happily ever after. Sooner or later, we realize there is no station, no one place to arrive at once and for all. The true joy of life is the trip. The station is only a dream. It constantly outdistances us. Relish the moment is a good motto. It isn't the burdens of today that drive men mad. It is the regrets over yesterday and the fear of tomorrow. Regret and fear are twin thieves who rob us of today. So stop pacing the aisles and counting the miles. Instead, climb more mountains, eat more ice cream, go barefoot more often, swim more rivers, watch more sunsets, laugh more, cry less. Life must be lived as we go along. The station will come soon enough. And now, ladies and gentlemen, I'm proud to present to you the Lord Botetourt High School class of 1996. Seniors, please come forward to receive your diploma.
Gregory Abbott. Heather Adkins. Tamara Agee. Allison Alley. Brian Atkinson. Amanda Barber. Marie Bowers. Bridget Basham. Christopher Bates. Gordon Bauer. Ryan Bays. Nathan Beasley. Chad Beck. Chris Benedetto. Michael Bissell. Valerie Blackner in absentia. Kelly Booz. Justin Borges. Christina Bowers. Melissa Sue Bryant. Jana Elizabeth Bird. Hope Ellen Cad. Lauren Carr. Nicholas Carroll. Nathan Charles. April Tuning. James Chitwood. Rebecca Crimes. Katrina calls. Mickey Cooper. Beverly Kraft. Julie Kraft in absentia. Timothy Kraft. Aaron Kreiser. Stephanie Crowder. Stacy Crumpacker. Tony Davidson. Nicole Davidson. Ashley Dillman. Kelly Dixon. Sarah Douglas. Michael Dowling. Kelly Drennan. Sarah Dudley. Brian Eberall. Robert Erickson. Jason Farmer. Jack Firebrand. Richard Ferguson. Jeremy Farrell. Nikki Firestone. Wendy Fisher. Natalie Fitzgerald. Lindsay Flaherty. Reagan Patricia Flaherty. Emily Fleet. Christy Ella Fons. Andrew Thomas Foster. James French. Timothy Brink. Laura Marie Garnett. Scott Garnett. Michael Edward Gates. Derek George. Stephanie Gill. Craig Goad. Yeah.
Diane Grable. Andrew Green. Brianna Greenway. Carrie Gross. Heather Hale. John Harold. Cynthia Harris. Timothy Harris. Emily Hartman. Justin Hatter. Travis Heath. Wendy Heath. Andrea Henderson. Teddy Holcomb. Jennifer Honeycutt. Bethany Hoops. Shane Hubbard. Christine Hunley. Natalie Israel. Richard Jeter. Michael Johnson. Tammy Johnson. Michael Carnes. Jamie Cassie. Ezra Keith. Holly Key. Beth Kilby. Molly Knox. Joseph Lackey. Mary Beth Leidenheim. Rocky Lark. Tammy Leonard. Autumn Light. Chris Littrell. James Livingood. Ann Mack. April Maddox. Wade MacArthur.
Nikki McCoy. Carrie McGlamoury. Clacy McGuffin. Brooke McMahon. Stephanie Meyer. Marissa Mahalski. Benjamin Miller. Leslie Nicole Miller. Ross Miller. Brandy Mixon. Allison Montgomery. John Mower. Paul Moore. Stephanie Moore. Crystal Moran. Elvis Mullins. Jeff Mundy. Jennifer Mary. Amber Musgrove. Michelle Nevergold. Shannon Newton. Andrew O'Connor. Michelle Oberg. Todd Oberg. Angela Ortiz. Joan Patterson. Michael Pauley. Robert Pauley. Jessica Pfeiffer. Emily Philpott. Jason Pearson. Christina Piero. William Potter. Kelly Rakes. Brandy Ray. Tracy Reed. Sh- Shane Ritchie. Amanda Robinson. Tiffany Rogers. Chad Sawyers in absentia. William Sellers. Christy Shank. Melissa Sharp. Carrie Showalter. Teresa Shoesberry. Chris Simcoe. Michael Simpson. Jennifer Sink. Ricky Smith. Laura Rebecca Smith. Teresa Snodgrass. Randall Snow. Susan Spath. Trevor Spillman. Scott Stafford. Tara Stanley. Cherie Stevens. John Stump. Angela Sweetberg. Rachel Taylor. Paul Theory. Nicole Thompson. Jessica Thompson. Jill Tolley. James Patrick Alma. Susanna Elizabeth Usack. Brad Bernamani. Gabriel Vernon. Stephanie Walters. Tanya Walters. Megan Elizabeth Ward. Justin Edward Warwick. Chris Chris Webb. Jody Wirtz. Jared Wessel. Amy Westmoreland. Wendy Whitlock. Michelle Worley. Elizabeth Williams. Suzanne Williams. Marcus Wilson. Susan Womack. Jennifer Yates. Stephanie Yost.
Seniors, now by the authority vested in me in the Commonwealth of Virginia, I declare that you're graduates of Lord Botetourt High School. You may turn your tassels.
Times in PE, to all the parties that we threw, driving the teachers crazy, but now it's nothing new. To all the times we came in late and they never said a word. To all the times in home ec, farewell to French onion soup. To the class where we learned about the store, where he brought the babies to. To all the shirts we've ever sewn and the patterns thrown away. And to all the world religions that we learned in history class. To all the great musicians that lived in the past. All the world's great artists, from Da Vinci to Serret. It's time for me to go my way. again. I won't see you again. And to you, my old friend, who I love so very much, we talked of everything right to the first girls we ever touched. All the things we've ever done, will they be good or bad? Now the time has come for you to go your way and I'll go mine. But through the years you'll always be somewhere on my mind. Always thought we'd be here forever and a day. But forever came yesterday.